It's Siskel and Ebert's Holiday Video Gift Guide.
Just like the ones I used to know.
Gene and Roger's annual unwrapping of the most wanted video and electronic gifts. From futuristic phones.
Could you just hold that pose because my kids are carving their pumpkin?
To the VCR you can talk to.
Stop.
Plus the latest and greatest in home video theaters. And Siskel and Ebert's giant selection of video gifts, from music to classic TV, from movie classics to the best in new releases. All on the Siskel and Ebert Holiday Video Gift Guide.
When I was a kid, I never wanted to get stuff like socks and shirts for Christmas. I wanted to get fun stuff, and I still feel that way on our annual Siskel and Ebert Holiday Video Gift Guide, a program devoted to video software and hardware gifts that you might want to give, or even better, receive this holiday season. I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times.
And I'm Gene Siskel of the Chicago Tribune, and you're right, Roger. I know that my newspaper asked me recently to name the best gift that I'd ever received, and I picked a transistor radio I got when I was 13 years old. And you're right, high-tech video gifts are the best gifts to receive.
For me, it was my Lionel train set.
Okay. Well, we're going to begin the gift guide, the video gift guide, looking at some new laser discs. Here is a laser disc for those of you who don't know. And this is the best format in which to see movies. You need a laser disc player, but they're being advertised right now for under $300. Take a look at these dazzling new scenes from a compilation of 22 Busby Berkeley production numbers from his Warner Brothers musicals in the 1930s. 3 hours of musical highlights, all dazzling, some kitschy, some racy, when they were made before the moralistic production code of 1934, like the Buy a Waterfall number from Footlight Parade. Another great laser disc is Stanley Kubrick's Spartacus, with sparkling images, as in this climactic battle sequence between the Romans and the slaves, with 10,000 extras. Often laser discs contain additional material besides the movie. The Spartacus disc from the Criterion Collection offers newsreel footage of the film's premiere, as well as a reminiscence by star Peter Ustinov, who won an Oscar for his portrait of a conniving slave trader.
I'm not a great expert on how much films cost, but there was a rumor, of course, that it was the most expensive film that was ever made, because the publicity departments always regarded such rumors as excellent.
Also from the Criterion Collection, a disc of The Harder They Come, the 1973 reggae thriller, featuring the songs and performance of Jimmy Cliff in the story of a Jamaican farm worker who becomes a reggae star and a revolutionary hero.
And then the harder they come, the harder they fall.
Jimmy Cliff in The Harder They Come, it's one of my favorite buried treasures, a wonderful cult film in which the CD caliber sound you just heard there and you get only from a laser disc is just as important as the improved imagery. Three terrific gift ideas for the holidays. They range in price from $40 for the Busby Berkeley compilation to $50 for The Harder They Come to $125 for the multi-disc, multi-part Spartacus.
And, of course, you can rent them, too.
Yep.
One of the most impressive laser discs out this season is the special widescreen collector's edition of Alien, the science fiction classic from 1979. The movie itself is seen in a remastered letterbox version. And then there are two entire sides devoted to additional material. For example, this behind-the-scenes footage of the alien being put through its paces. Another gift idea: of the four actors who have played James Bond, my favorite is, of course, Sean Connery, the original 007, and my favorite Bond movies are the first three that he starred in, Dr. No, From Russia With Love, and Goldfinger. All three are now part of a deluxe letterbox edition called the Connery Collection, and here's a scene featuring my favorite Bond villain, the infamous Goldfinger himself.
Do you expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
And one of the funniest movies in years is out on Laserdisc, and take two is La Cage aux Folles, the story of a gay father who fears his lifestyle will embarrass the straight son he hasn't seen in years. Unlikely comic material, but it's hilarious.
Ça, c'est John Wayne, jeune fille.
Alors, PD.
And that's still funny.
Yeah.
You know, Gene, you were talking about some of the special features on Laserdiscs, and one of the best things that I like about them is the way they can have three separate and distinct soundtracks on each side of the disc. So that, for example, on that Spartacus disc that you were talking about,
right,
one of the tracks is a narration about the film by a lot of the people who were involved in it, like Peter Ustinov, and they're mm-hmm. talking about the film while they're watching it again after right. all those years. It's like sitting next to the guy while he's sitting through his own film.
The other thing that I want to deal with is why more people don't have laserdiscs. We've been talking about it for years, and I think that they're, one, afraid of the technology, just generally. Let me use myself as an example, because I'm
afraid of all technology.
I am,
yeah.
But I got a laserdisc very early on, and they're really quite simple. All you have to do is buy this little machine and slip it in and push a button. It's very simple.
Like a tape. You just plug it into your TV and start playing the disc.
It's very easy to operate.
Need to be any smarter than you are to operate.
Thank you.
Every year on this holiday video gift guide, we play with some of the new electronic gizmos that are on the market, and this year our research led us to the new AT&T video phones. Technology that allows you to see who you're talking to. I sometimes feel I see enough of Gene already, but I called him up on my video phone.
Okay, I'm going to try to place a call to Gene on this AT&T video phone.
I'm about to go to bed, and each night before I go to bed, I'd like to know that Roger is safe. Hello?
Oh, hi, Gene. How are you?
Fine, thanks. Are you safe? You're okay?
Yes, I'm fine. Yes, were you concerned?
How was the flight? All right?
Oh, it was all right,
good.
Yes.
All right. You got in?
Yes. Well, we had a lot of turbulence.
Are you under the covers now?
No.
What?
You don't need to be a rocket scientist to use this AT&T video phone. It plugs into a regular phone jack and power outlet, and then you dial. You hit the blue button marked video, and this telephone starts sending a picture as well as your voice to the phone at the other end of the call. But how good is the picture?
Oh, look at that. You see? Now, the strange thing is that you kind of move in little kind of slow-motion special effects there.
But the most important thing to think about is the cost. The phone calls themselves aren't any extra, but these machines list for about $1,500 each. At that price, you want to get a pretty good view of who's at the other end.
As I look at you here, you bear an amazing resemblance to Henry the serial killer.
Thank you. And
it's
Roger?
Okay.
My kid, could you just hold that pose, because my kids are carving their pumpkin.
Gene and I conducted a series of highly non-scientific experiments to see how well the AT&T video phone worked. First, Gene wanted to show me what was holding up his pants.
Okay, but Raj, can you tell anything special about the belt? Does it look plain to you?
No, it looks like it's a belt. I can't see any details. I see a little
glint. There's a little,
it looks like it might be a buckle.
There's a little sewn edge. Yeah,
What this shot reminds me of more than anything else is Lyndon Johnson pointing to his gallbladder scar.
Then I wanted to see if Gene could identify one of my favorite desktop characters.
Hey, there's Mickey.
Can you see him?
Very cute.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Do you sleep with that?
No, I don't, Gene, as a matter of fact.
Finally, we'd had enough of the phones and each other.
All right, I'm going to go brush my teeth. I'll see you.
I wish you would. Even over the video phone, I could see that you need to.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
And this technology is still being perfected. For example, MCI claims to have a video phone that's going to come out early next year,
right,
cost half as much, and have a better picture. But it still leaves me with the question, do I want a video phone?
Yes.
And you know, for me, the answer is most of the time, no.
Right.
I think one of the real advantages of a telephone that I would pay extra for is the fact that I can talk on it without being visible to anyone.
And I'm sure the people who are receiving calls from you appreciate it as well.
I'm sure that's
the case. I think that we'll have to see. If it were high quality, and again, if you could afford, and that's going to be an issue throughout this whole show, is just how much people can afford. But it's only, I think, in the case of the distant relative where you want to stay in contact with.
Maybe a courting couple, you know, who have to be separated for some reason.
Yeah, I mean, no, there are married couples that have two jobs in different cities. I could see that maybe occurring. But it's not a must-buy.
No, it isn't. Coming up next, some of the big hits on video this season and some sleepers you might enjoy. And later in the program, I take computerized piano lessons and we'll look at the new system that allows you to put photographs on television.
What video would you like to find under the Christmas tree this Christmas? What movie would you like on video?
Sand Pebbles.
Continuing our holiday gift guide special full of video gift ideas, how about the challenge of buying someone a movie they might actually want to own? Beauty and the Beast tops my list because Children can and will want to watch this classic over and over. And if you see the film more than once, you're going to start noticing things like the details in the corners of the screen, like that coat rack that becomes a violinist during the title tune.
Just a little change.
The movie is available on tape, but a widescreen version of the film as a work in progress is available on Laserdisc. This includes line drawings as the film was being made.
I've never felt this way about anyone.
Also worth owning is Bugsy, directed by Barry Levinson and featuring Warren Beatty's best performance in more than a decade. It's a superior film about a mobster's fascination with Hollywood stardom and also Hollywood's fascination with mobsters.
Bugsy? What do you mean by Bugsy?
I beg your pardon.
A bug is nothing. A bug does not exist. The word has no meaning. It's only used out of ignorance or malice. Do you know what a bug is? A bug is a colloquialism. It has no basis in reality. Insects include a wide variety of living creatures. They fly, they crawl, they do many things. None of them can be called a bug. Are you following me? Because if you aren't...
I am. I certainly didn't mean any offense, Mr. Siegel.
Ben.
And he'll end up making that guy an offer he can't refuse for his house. Bugsy was run over by Silence of the Lambs at the Oscars, yeah. But that doesn't in any way alter its quality. I think it is worth owning.
It is. It's a good film. Also recommended on video this season is the movie I thought was the best film of last year, Oliver Stone's JFK. A film so complex and rich with so many layers of fiction and fact, documentary and speculation, that it's the kind of film you really want to see more than once, if only just to figure it out. Kevin Costner starred as District Attorney Jim Garrison, who was convinced there was a conspiracy to assassinate John F. Kennedy.
Guess who used his address? Lee Harvey Oswald.
Now, if you're thinking of buying JFK, you might want to wait until January the 20th when Warner Brothers is bringing out a special director's cut in which Oliver Stone adds 17 and a half minutes of additional footage, including this scene speculating about a conspiracy involving a fired CIA official and his brother, the mayor of Dallas.
Talk about the Fox investigating chicken coop. Now we'll have to subpoena them both.
And at the opposite end of almost every imaginable spectrum from JFK, another video I'm recommending is Wayne's World, which was hilarious as it detailed the adventures of a couple of suburban cable TV hosts who went looking for good times and great babes.
Hi, Wayne. Hi.
Hey, are you all right?
And you know, the funny thing about Wayne's World, which I laugh
at
from beginning to end, is it's seemingly very dumb, but it's actually very smart.
Oh, it's very smart. I mean, first of all, to have the guts to, you know, show the characters laughing at her. I mean, I
know.
That's what anyone would do. I mean, at least they had the guts to show it.
Now let's move on to another category of holiday gift video. Good movies that maybe didn't get all of the attention they deserve, but that we recommend you catch up with on tapes or discs. Sort of buried treasures. And right at the top of my list is One False Move, one of this year's best films, which stars Cindy Williams as one of three fugitives who flee from Los Angeles to Arkansas, and Bill Paxton as the sheriff whose job is to arrest her, even though they share an old and deeply buried secret.
I want you to go back in the kitchen and stay there until I tell you to come out. That way, in case they get trigger happy, you'll be out of a line of fire.
Another movie that didn't get the attention it deserved was Lawrence Kasdan's Grand Canyon, a movie that seemed even more timely and hopeful after the Los Angeles riots of last spring. It starred Kevin Kline and Danny Glover as two men from opposite sides of town who met by accident and then became friends in a city increasingly isolated by race and class divisions.
Is that what you thought it was?
Yeah, that, and, you know, the white guy.
You white?
Yeah, I really like that movie, and I like the way that it made me feel at the end, because I think there is hope, even despite all of the terrible things that we saw on television during those riots in Los Angeles.
Yeah, I think it's an important film. I think I had it number three on my best list of 1991. Here are two more overlooked films worth thinking about as gifts. Europa, Europa from Germany was the controversial Oscar nominee about a Jewish boy who pretends to be a Nazi youth in order to survive World War II. It's an epic story from director Agnieszka Holland.
Hey.
Mississippi Masala features the charismatic Denzel Washington, currently starring as Malcolm X, as a carpet cleaner who falls in love with an East Indian motel worker, Sarita Chaudhuri. Their love affair brings together characters we rarely see in the movies, fully written minorities.
I know you and your folks can come down here from God knows where and be about as black as the ace of spades, and as soon as you get here, you start acting white and treating us like we your doormats. I know that you and your daughter ain't but a few shades from this right here. That I know.
Well, it's a terrific film, quite romantic, and also challenging. And it's interesting, the pictures that we just picked as overlooked are the ones that deal with race, with life as it is really lived. And that's where the excitement is in the American cinema right now.
That's right.
Coming up next on the Video Gift Guide, the video piano teacher, a machine that will help Roger learn how to play the piano in just a few hours. We hope.
I guess The Wizard of Oz, because it meant the most to me. It was like, it represents my childhood to me.
Might as well start out by telling you that all of my life I wanted to play the piano, all except for 3 months, of course, in the fourth grade, when I actually took piano lessons, and then I hated them. There had to be another way that I could learn the instrument so that I could, you know, just like in those old magazine ads, I could amaze my friends at parties. And maybe there is. This is a new computerized approach to piano learning called the Miracle Piano System, and it's available for computers or for video game systems. Okay, this is the Miracle Piano System, which I have connected here to my Macintosh computer, although you could also use it with an IBM clone or with a Nintendo using exactly the same keyboard. And it's a colorful and interesting way to learn to play piano on your own. This keyboard and software for my Macintosh costs about $500, but you can get the lower-tech Nintendo version for about $380, and there's a Super Nintendo version as well with better graphics. They give you the keyboard, but of course you already have to have the Nintendo player. Well, how does it work? First, the Miracle Piano takes you through all kinds of practice techniques to start your lessons, like the basic notes. C, E, D, C, okay. Then there's a duck shooting game to see if you can nail the right notes. The ducks are flying out on the lines where certain notes would be on sheet music, and if you hit the right note, you shoot the duck. And look at that. I got every single duck. Once you shoot enough ducks or learn enough notes, it's on to Beethoven's Ode to Joy. The Miracle Piano first teaches me the tune phrase by phrase. Not bad. See? Finally, I can play a complete stretch of that famous melody. Next, I have to go into the Miracle Program's practice room and work on my timing with a metronome. When I get close enough to the correct tune and timing, I get to perform one more time with a full orchestra. Now, you know, Jane, the amazing thing about this system is, for me, it was better than a piano teacher, because I probably would have resented the piano teacher sitting there and telling me to practice. But with the computer, it says, well, you got 77%. You want to try to do a little bit better? Mm-hmm. Or instead of saying you got 6 wrong notes, they say you didn't shoot 6 ducks. You know, let's just go back and shoot some more ducks. I believe that I could learn to play the piano using this system. I firmly believe that.
How long do you think it would take you to be good enough to sit down and amaze your friends? Seriously.
I think it would probably take a long time.
How long? A year?
They say in the literature that it might take you a year, but at the end of a year, they say you can play songs, you can read music, you can play with other musicians, and you can improvise songs at the end of a year. Right now, I'm up to Mary Had a Little Lamb, and later on in the show, I have another composition I want to play for you.
Okay, well, how about some real music available on home video? Music laser discs are more likely played enough times to warrant purchase. Here are a couple of my recommendations, starting with popular soprano Kathleen Battle at the Metropolitan Museum, singing 17 pieces, including Gershwin and Puccini, as well as a familiar spiritual. Of rock music, another terrific laser disc, Lou Reed, Magic and Loss, featuring many reflective melodic songs about the meaning of life, such as What's Good?
What good is
this life without living? What good's this lion that barks? You love the life of this throwaway nightly. It's not fair. Not fair at all. What's good?
And I think it helps to see the artist while you're listening to them sing. I think in that case, I could focus on his mouth. I could follow the complicated lyrics, and I enjoyed it more because of that.
With a good sound system and a lot of attention to the sound, you can really have a concert experience, I believe. And, you know, there are a lot of stores around the country that are specializing in music video. It's a little subsection of the music and the video business that's really growing. My choices of great music on video includes one of the all-time best and best-selling opera videos, the all-star benefit performance, Carreras, Domingo, and Pavarotti in concert. Another recommended video, Time Will Tell, Bob Marley and the Wailers, which contains not only documentary footage showing how Bob Marley and reggae became a musical and social force in Jamaica and around the world, but also has some great numbers like No Woman, No Cry. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. And this is a tape version of a documentary which is actually quite new, even though Bob Marley has been dead for quite a while. This movie just came out last year, and now it's on video. Still ahead on our annual gift guide, a new system that allows you to store photos on compact disc, plus video collections for all kinds of tastes, and our annual tour through some of the best home video setups you're going to see anywhere.
Well, the three films that had the greatest impact on me, so it could be one of those three. It could be either Fantasia, Singing in the Rain, or The Treasure of Sierra Madre. Nice schizophrenic great answer, right?
On your TV screen as well as regular music compact discs. Does that sound unnecessary? I thought so, until I tried it.
You're looking at a series of still photos we took here in the city of Chicago, regular photographs developed in the regular way.
And now you're looking at the same photographs on a television set. How is that accomplished? With the Kodak Photo CD player. That's right, photographs stored on a compact disc. You can get your film developed at your local photo store and pay about $20 for a roll of 24 shots on a disc to play through this CD machine. What do you get when you buy the Kodak Photo CD player? You get a CD player like this. It can play regular CDs, all your music, as well as these CD discs with all the photographs on them, and you get this remote control device too. And that little remote control provides most of the fun for this system. With it, you can play the photos in any order you like, or you can manipulate images by cropping them to change a shot you don't like. This lets me take just a section of the photograph. All right, now I don't want that part. I might want more of the fire hydrant, so I'm going to move it over. And now let's take a look. And I really see the thickness of the paint on the photograph. In fact, I think you'd argue that that is a much more pleasing and interesting photograph than the one we saw before. The machine we're talking about costs about $550, but remember, it's also a regular musical audio CD player. And if you don't care about manipulating or cropping the pictures on the screen, a simpler system costs $450. And here you can see the quality is really quite good. On the left here, we're showing you a regular still photo. And on the right, the compact CD picture, there's not much difference. And with regular still photos, you can't have the fun I had with this machine. So, would I buy it? Well, I'm not into photographs that much, so I probably wouldn't. And at $550 average cost, this definitely is a luxury item. But if I didn't own a CD player and I wanted one, and if I were a photography nut, I would enjoy the compact storage. You get a whole bunch of photographs in just this little thing. And the cropping ability afforded by the Kodak CD player would really recommend it, I think. It could be a lot of fun to mess around with.
I'm more intrigued in it than you are, Gene. And one of the things I know about this system, being a computer nut, which I am, is that you can actually connect these photographs to your computer, download the photographs onto the computer disk, size them, and put them into documents Like those little letters that people send out at Christmas time. You could rent pictures of your family and tell people what you've been doing.
And bore them in print and in photographs.
That's right. Now let's move on to video collectibles. Sets of tapes or discs that you might want to consider adding to your permanent collection. When I started going to the movies, they always played a color cartoon before the main feature. And now dozens of the greatest cartoon classics are available in beautiful box sets of five discs each, selling for $99. Here's a sample from the golden age of Looney Tunes. And that's not all, folks. Robert Altman remains one of the most inventive and original of all modern movie directors. And he demonstrates that in Tanner 88, an 11-part series that was filmed during the 1988 presidential campaigns. It played on HBO. It has now finally been released on Laserdisc. Altman used actor Michael Murphy to play a fictional presidential candidate named Tanner and ran him in the primaries right alongside the real candidates.
Well, the Republicans are going to be tough this year, but we wish you the best.
Looking tougher all the time. Congratulations.
And I have the strangest impression there that Pat Robertson thinks that Tanner really is some Democrat he just hasn't heard of yet. The result is uncanny, a behind-the-scenes look at a fake political campaign that seems more convincing sometimes than some of the real ones.
Well, I think that's something that I would be intrigued enough to actually certainly rent and maybe buy. My collectible suggestions begin with a wonderful four-disc, four-film collection called Rediscovering Myrna Loy. Myrna Loy was a huge star in the 30s, although today best known for her Thin Man films with William Powell. She also co-starred with Clark Gable in films like Manhattan Melodrama from 1934.
Up to a minute ago, I loved you very dearly. You were all that mattered to me. But right now, I can't even remember having been in love with you.
I also strongly recommend a collection called Monty Python's Parrot Sketch Not Included, featuring classic bits from 20 years of offbeat comedy from the English comedy troupe. The tape begins with this clever introduction from Steve Martin.
Funny. Brilliantly funny. But enough about me. What about this Monty Python crowd?
It also includes classic Python sketches like this famous bit.
He's a lumberjack, he's all fame. He sits all night and he works all day.
I cut down trees, I skip and jump. I like to press wildflowers. I put on women's clothing and hang around in bars.
You know, there's an innocence to that tape. There's a sweetness to it that I think has really gone from a lot of humor today.
I like the moment when the Mounties begin to realize what they're saying.
Yeah, very good. The Monty Python material is available on tape, and I think people do get their money's worth from comedy material. The good ones, the good tapes and discs, are really worth playing more than once.
Coming up next, yet another product to help people who can't program their VCRs. And also more video gift ideas for kids, from potty training to a hit movie.
I would like probably several copies, please, of Beauty and the Beast, so that my daughter can have one on each floor.
Roger repeats it over and over and over. The technology is not my bag. I have yet to successfully program a VCR. I think I wear that as a badge of honor. And this year, there's yet another product for people who have the same problem. It's called the VCR Voice Programmer, and I tested it out. All right, let's see if we can make this VCR voice programmer work. And one of the things we have to do right away is train it to recognize the sound of our voice. So this is going to give me all sorts of cues to say certain words that you use in programming your VCR, and I'll have to say them. It'll be imprinted here, encoded, and then it will be recognized when I use it again. So here comes the training exercise. This ought to be very amusing for everybody but me. Friday, 12, Tuesday. While I'm loading up the VCR voice programmer, we'll go through some important consumer information. This little toy has a list price of $169. Up to four family members can store their voices in the machine. So how well does it work? Okay, let's see if the VCR voice programmer recognizes my voice. And in addition to programming your VCR, it also allows you to operate your VCR. So you're in the corner of your bedroom or something and you want to yell out a command to, you know, just play something. Didn't want to say it too loud for the machine to hear me. To play something, let's see if it works. Here we go. I press VCR and then I'm going to issue a command. Play.
Fast forward. Stop. Now let's see if we can get the VCR voice program to actually respond to my voice and record a television program just using my voice. In the past, using my head and my hands has not worked. Here come the prompts to tell me to use my voice. 2. Saturday. 6. 30. P.M. 7. P.M. All plugged in. I want to watch Channel 2, Saturday. 6:30 is the start time, P.M. End time, 7 o'clock, P.M. That's when the Siskel and Ebert Show plays here in Chicago. Okay, let's see if the VCR voice programmer really works. I'm going to press, let's see if it really recorded our show. Here we go. Press the VCR button and then say the magic word. Play.
I think if you push the tape in, Gene, it will probably work better. Okay, now why don't you try it again?
That really does help, huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Play.
Hey! Well, hey, it's our show. Hey, congratulations.
It actually works.
Remember, you push the tape in, or otherwise, you can't push the tape in for itself.
You're such a smarty pants.
Yeah, okay.
However, you know, if you know about the VCR Plus system, an alternative, which we tested on the show last year, you're going to be better off. Why? Because it costs one-third the price of the VCR voice programmer, and all you have to do to make it work is type in those numbers listed next to the TV shows in your newspaper listings or in TV Guide. The only problem with the VCR Plus, you're just not going to be able to yell at it.
Oh, I yell at it a lot, but we do have a VCR Plus, and I agree
right.
with you, it's better than the voice system. Now it's time for our next set of video recommendations, and the category is Kid Vid. And my first choice, in all seriousness, I might add, is a musical tape named It's Potty Time, which I looked at because this is a major bestseller around the country. It uses the sing-along techniques of other popular kiddie videos to teach its young viewers about one of the indispensable social skills.
It's okay if you don't need to go right now, Katie. Just let me know when you do need to go to the potty.
Okay. Now, quite a different movie, one recommended for adults as well as kids, Jason and the Argonauts, a simply spectacular film from 1963. Among the film's amazing scenes is the climatic battle between Jason and a group of ghostly skeletons. The supplemental material on this disc shows how special effects master Ray Harryhausen filmed the battle twice, once with only the actors and again with numbered stuntmen standing in for the skeletons. And here's the final version of the scene.
Fabulous.
And that is a 30-year-old film in its freshest complete.
Yes, it is.
And it's really interesting to see the whip because they show you how the actors are in back projection and the tabletop animated models are in front and how they put it together. And it looked pretty convincing.
It looks very good. And we've gone, obviously, through a special effects revolution in the motion picture industry. That still works very well. Only Jason looks a little dated. Now, my kid video suggestions include Beethoven, a hit movie this past summer, about a family whose lives are changed after they adopt a baby St. Bernard. Charles Grodin is very funny as the dog-hating dad. And for small children, I'd like to recommend Farm Animals Close Up and Very Personal, which is great for little ones who can't get to a petting zoo. You know, I like those shots. When I go with my kids to, like, a county fair and we look at the farm animals, you want to see how they make the sound. So getting really tight and seeing, you know, the tongue make the sound, it's
great.
Was
this really the best kid vid you could find?
This is...
Close-ups of sheep?
Roger, this is... You laughed about... I'm not going to laugh about potty training. This is also a bestseller, too, and it is very highly recommended. And if you are blessed with little ones, you're going to buy it.
Well, I think if I were that age, I'd rather learn about my potty techniques than look at those sheep.
What scares me is that I know that you would. That tape, by the way, only costs $15, and I think it's worth it. Next, we're going to take you on our annual tour of spectacular media rooms where home video quality is getting better and better.
Well, I'll be shameless, the player.
And why?
Because no one sent me a copy of it.
City Slickers.
Why? Because I'm in it and I have points.
And now it's fantasy time on our holiday video gift guide special, the time when money is no object because these are the kind of gifts you're going to give only to yourself. The fantasy of having your own media room watching big screen, really big screen movies and TV. We're going to look at two such fantasies realized, one meant to be hidden away in a room which also serves as a family room, and the other, a room that proudly announces itself as a mini movie palace. You're looking at a dream under construction, a room which will serve two purposes when finished, as both a quiet family room and as a top-of-the-line media room. But the people who own this home have a lot of problems to deal with. Problems pointed out in a tour of the room by Tony Grimani, who works for LucasArts Entertainment, a company founded by George Lucas to create the superb THX sound system, now available in a home system going into this media room.
First thing I noticed was this channel over here. You see these three neatly concealed speakers in the ceiling. Are supposed to be providing the center channel information in the motion picture soundtrack. These speakers are going to beam right down into the floor, and of course, the listener is not going to hear them.
All right, we're back in the media room now. A couple of months later, the project is almost finished. They have a way of going on a little longer than you suspect. Allow for that. How did they handle the three center channel speakers? Well, it's reduced to one big speaker, relatively big, placed in the center of the room. It's going to be placed on coasters and will be able to slide back when not in use into the media wall cabinet. The next problem also had to do with speakers, the rear speakers, which are so important to a surround sound system.
The surround channel in a film soundtrack should provide a sound field that's enveloping, that simulates what you have in real life when you have background noise and when you have effects, sounds that pan over your head. The best way to place these surround speakers is actually quite a bit higher in the wall.
And here is the original location of those rear surround sound speakers, which has been raised to here, which is much better. And a speaker will be placed in here. It will be covered with fabric to match the upholstered walls. And there was one other important audio problem to deal with, and it's caused by the room itself.
You can probably hear my voice right now. It sounds very reverberant, very echoey, and we don't want that.
Now listen to my voice. There's no echo in the room. How is that achieved? By upholstering the walls. There's padding behind this fabric. It gives you a bounce here, but no bouncing of voices. Well, that takes care of the sound. Now, how do you get the best picture available? It doesn't look like there's any way to see a picture in this bright room, but hit a couple of switches, and the blackout shades roll down to cover the French doors and the large windows. An 8-foot diagonal screen slides out of a ceiling well. Turn on the overhead Panasonic industrial projector and kick in this Faruja video processor, a machine that's capable of doubling video images so that you get a much cleaner picture. Turn out the lights and you're in video heaven. One final note, the owners of this room realized that they would probably be watching more television than movies, and as a result, they invested in all of this high-tech equipment, but they also invested in one other thing, and that is a satellite dish placed on their roof to give them pure signal, video signal, and pure signal sound. The result is an astonishing picture that I think anticipates HDTV. It is certainly of that quality. And so you've come from this to this. The best in home video in a room that can hide it all away.
And this is the kind of home theater that people build or they want to go to the movies without ever leaving home. It has its own marquee. It's the Lyric Theater. It has its own ticket seller, Oliver Hardy. And let's go inside and look at all the bells and whistles.
Inside, you'll find a miniature movie palace, an 11-seat theater that really looks like a movie house. It's one of several home theater layouts available from Theater Design Associates of New York. That company says it can install one of these babies in a day, prefab. But the owner of this house and the electronics expert who helped him found out that's only under certain conditions.
This particular room had to be done custom because the length wasn't quite long enough to set it up.
Yeah.
Our ceiling height was lower. There were soffits in here that had to be taken into consideration. So everything was done on a custom basis.
Now, if you had a room that was the right size, what would it cost you for this theater, not counting the electronic equipment?
Around $25,000.
When you spend that much on the room, you're going to want the latest in video technology, and this room has it. There's a home version of the Lucas THX sound system with special amps and speakers to surround you with movie sound. A top-of-the-line Pioneer laser disc player gives the best quality pictures, and this cutting-edge Harman video projector gives you the next best thing to high-definition delivery. Give us a ballpark figure on this electronic equipment, the sound and the video.
About $35,000.
So this room altogether is around $60,000.
Correct.
You heard it right. The cost of the equipment in that video-dedicated room is approximately $35,000. But for an HDTV equivalent room right now, well, if you got the dough, that doesn't seem nuts to me.
I have not yet experienced satellite, although I know the people who do have satellite TV systems love them.
Right.
I'll tell you this about big screen projection TV. It looks terrific,
yeah.
And it's really come a long way since those days that a lot of people are familiar with, where you would go into the sports bar and you have to line up right in front
yes.
of the set in order to see the picture.
Yes.
Now you can look at it from any angle, just like a movie.
Even if you don't have the money, I think one of the messages on this section of the show that we're really giving is that it is worth checking out because the technology is really quite
advanced.
You know,
Gene, both Sharp and Panasonic have one-lens systems that
yeah.
cost a good deal less, around the $1,000, $2,000 mark for
yeah.
a 40-inch or a 50-inch picture, and that's not bad. Our next video segment is one that has been one of our most popular over the years, maybe because a lot of people like to collect tapes of classic TV shows. I have a couple of recommendations, and one is A Classic Christmas from Ed Sullivan, which includes great moments from many different Ed Sullivan holiday shows, including this one, where Bing Crosby visited the set to chat with Ed about his most famous song.
But there was another one that he slipped in that picture that became the hit of the show.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Also recommended, now out on tape, the complete Fawlty Towers, starring John Cleese as the haphazard proprietor of the faultiest hotel in Britain. Who can ever forget the day they mistakenly sealed up the entrance to the dining room?
Good morning, Major. I'm so sorry. I've heard the dining room door seems to have disappeared.
Have you ever seen Fawlty Towers?
I have not.
This is one of the funniest shows that ever was on television. It didn't make very many of them. And it's just hilarious because John Cleese here is the most foul-tempered person.
I like the extra little kick
ever
game.
Seen
the guy's already on the ground.
A lot of fun.
Well, watching vintage TV is one of my favorite pastimes. I love the old quiz shows, even if you're not sure which games were fixed and which weren't. Here's a classic moment from the $64,000 challenge from 1956 with special guest star Vincent Price. The subject is art. His competitor, the jockey Billy Pearson. Remember him? He was a $64,000 question winner.
What great artist designed the incomparable bell tower in Florence in 1334?
Giotto.
Giotto is right for $1,000.
And here's a classic Jack Benny show featuring no less a guest star than Humphrey Bogart from 1953, 4 years before his death, playing what else? A gangster.
I'm entitled to one phone call, ain't I?
Well, yes.
Okay, give me a dime and I'll run down to the drugstore.
Oh, no, you don't.
Very funny. It was thrilling back then to see big movie stars live on TV. They also seem sort of undone by their own fame in the harsh light of black and white TV. Both of these vintage TV classics are available from the Shokas Video Catalog, the best source of vintage TV. We'll give you their phone number in the credits at the end of the show. Get a pencil ready. It's worth sticking around.
Coming up, we'll see if I've gotten any better at the Miracle Piano System since I first tried it.
I'll take Dog Day Afternoon.
Why?
Well, I don't know why.
Now we're back with the Miracle Piano System, and I want to emphasize this is available for Macintosh, IBM-compatible computers, and Nintendo systems.
Right.
And I have prepared a holiday song, Gene, and I thought that if I had...
Is it a complicated one?
No, I don't think so.
Why? How long have you been playing, actually? How many hours did you put in your three
You're looking,
sessions?
Gene, at a guy who has spent a good 2 hours learning to play the piano.
Okay? Really dedicated.
So if I play, I want you to sing.
If I know the song, I shall.
I think you might. Here we go.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle all the way. This is sort of an American version of karaoke. And as we always say at this time of year, at the end of the holiday video gift guide, season screenings, everyone. Jingle bells,
vibraphone.
Jingle bells, harpsichord. Organ. Synthesizer. Electric piano. Vibraphone. Hey, Lionel Hampton.
Here's a great Christmas gift for your VCR. It's the 1993 edition of Roger Ebert's movie Home Companion. Full-length reviews, interviews, and more. It's America's favorite jelly bean, Jelly Belly, now appearing at theaters and video stores with good taste. Jelly Belly beans, try them, you'll love them. Sundance puts family refreshment in a whole new light. Sparkling water, pure fruit juice, less than 10 calories per serving. Great-tasting new Sundance Light. Gravity Cologne for men, more than a fragrance, it's a force of nature. You couldn't resist it even if you tried.
Try the left hand. Let's see.
I can't play anything with the left
hand. Let's show us.
Well, first of all, it's chords. And the problem with the chords is I can't get my... See, I can't get this finger.
Your fourth finger. You can't get it to move? Bad. You're playing only one chord over and over and over.
I can't play anything with my left hand. Of course this is good.